Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbi ajmain. Alhamdulillah, we are now training you in terms of coaching and we have this growth model GROWTH and I have explained to you we are at the first level, that is G is for goal, R is for reality check, O is for obstacle and also option, W is for way forward or wheel, T is for tactics and H for habits. So GROWTH, just remember the acronym, very simple. All right, so today I'm going to give you more ideas about how we are going to go to get our client or coachee, how they are going to do their goal setting. Remember, goal setting is important for us to achieve success in life, to achieve success in business, to achieve success in education, to achieve success in family development. And I have mentioned to you that within the framework of Islamic psychology, we are talking about the spiritual, emotional, mental and physical realm. All right? So our goal setting naturally would want to cover the whole spectrum of the spiritual, emotional, mental and physical, but we start at the bottom. That means we start at the P level, because modern humanity has lost a lot of link towards the spirituality of the self. So when we are coaching somebody who has no idea of the practices of Islam, no idea of the practices of, for example, Salah, maybe they fast. There are a lot of, for example, in Malaysia, they don't pray 5 times a day, but they fast in the month of Ramadan. They still remember that fasting aspect. So they are practicing one small aspect of Islam. Alhamdulillah. We don't condemn them, but these are the people who are searching for a meaning and purpose in life. So that's why in the holistic approach that we are going to do, our goal setting will cover both, starting at the physical aspect, I mean aspect of their life insofar as they're having difficulties in terms of their negative thoughts, they're having problem with their family, they're having problem with video addiction or handphone addiction, or they have certain amount of depression, they are feeling the pressure of trying to find a job, they are jobless, they have sexual pressure because they already reach a level of, for example, they're 26, 27 years old, but they have no job, they have no way of getting married. So many issues that our young people are facing. So we cannot hide like a ostrich, put our head under the ground and say it doesn't exist, whereas the whole body of the challenges and problems of the ummah is so obvious. That's why we have to take this approach of coaching. That's why we start with these 4 levels that I'm telling you of how I'm inshallah going to train based on my experience as a human resource consultant, as a leadership consultant, as a productivity consultant in my good old days, that I'm using those skills in terms of coaching, mentoring. So we start with motivation. So I've given you the motivation aspect, then now we're giving the coaching aspect, then the mentoring aspect, then inshallah finally the positive Islamic psychology, cognitive behavior therapy in terms of counseling, which I have given you in a lot of the videos in Islamic psychology PIP YouTube. You open, you have plenty of those for you to search, all right, and study. Okay, so when we talk about goal setting, remember it's two way. You as a coach, you must have your goals, all right? And your goals will consist naturally at the 4 levels. The physical aspect of your goals in terms of your life, in terms of maybe, for example, your financial resources, what are the financial resources that you want, in terms of the house or the car, whatever you want, you may have that goal, all right? Then you have the mental goal in terms of your knowledge, infusion of learning, how you can have become a lifelong learner and so on. And then you have your emotional goal in terms of your relationship with your wife, with your children, how are you going to bring them up to become wonderful Muslims living in Iman, Islam and Ihsan, how you can have the joy of a big family, not only yourself, your wife, your mother-in-law, your father-in-law, your family, grandfather, grandmother, and so on. So this whole big spectrum of a family unit in Islam. And then at a higher level of our ubudiyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of our spirituality, of our ibadah, of our prayer, of our zakat, our fast, our hajj, the basic of the fiqh, wajibun, that we have to do. And then the extra in terms of our effort, in terms of our tazkiyah, in terms of our muraqabah, muhasabah. And then at the little level, we also think about how we going to contribute our life to sacrifice a small amount to become a true and sincere servant of Allah. Just like this book, as I say, we are trying to establish ourselves as a caliph of Allah, only striving to make ourselves good, help others to be good, and make the world good with the grace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the only thing that we need to do. So I'm applying the Khalifa method, the Khalifa principle, laid down by the late Professor Muhammad Mahdi Jenkins. He saw that as the most positive worldview ever for any human being, Muslims and non-Muslims, to understand that you are created to be the vicegerent of God on this earth. It is such an honor. It's such a great thing. And we must be able to infuse this idea of being the Caliph of Allah to our kochi in whatever small manner that we can, gradually as we go along. So the goal setting system is, we want to give the person something to look forward to. Alright, so that's why we have goal setting. It is not a 1 year off kind of thing. Oh, you know, a lot of people say, okay, I set my goal, say this is 2019, alright, 31st December 2018, they make a goal and then that's it. But they never follow up. A goal that is never follow up, a goal setting, is just a wishful thinking. It must be followed up. The same thing, if you want to coach somebody, they have a problem, a very specific problem, then you must tell them to work out their problem at the first level, in which we tackle the most immediate problem that they have. For example, say the short term, what they need to do, the mid-term and the long-term. And that is only talking about one aspect of their life. Remember, we are not putting all the SEMP or PMES, the other way around, the hierarchy of needs, as I explained to you in the previous video. For example, we have this girl, all right, I'm giving you the same example, who is obese and she's being teased at school, all right? So she is, say, 16 years old in the secondary school, and she is overweight. Alright, so the short term goal will be that this girl, say, her name is, for example, say, Sally, Sally is overweight. Okay, by, say, 40 kilos, which is quite a lot for a girl, extra 40 kilos. That means if her standard weight, if her body mass and so on, you find out, alright, a certain range, she is, could be a big size girl or a small size girl, you can go to the body mass index and you say, okay, they know she's overweight by 40 kg. So then you are going to help her because she is depressed now. She's having depression. Alright, but not severe. Remember, if it's very severe depression where she's seeing self-harm, for example, she's already cutting her hand or doing self-harm and all that, that is beyond you. That you got to go to a psychiatrist, you got to go to a psychologist, where she will have to go through proper counseling. Remember, this is more of, she's depressed, she's sad, but she's not at a level where it is very, very severe. She's very unhappy, she is withdrawal, she's not in the group, she just stay at home. Alright, she doesn't go out with her friends and so on because of the teasing and all, because of her weight issue. So she's depressed but not severe, so you can help her. So when you work with her, you can tell her about how she can implement her life in terms of the short-term goal. Because if you want to go 40 kg straight away, you want to lose 40 kg, it's an easy thing. So her long-term goal will be 40 kg. Alright? Her short-term goal should be 2 kg. So 2 kg in, say, 2 weeks, which is achievable, 1 kg a week. So then mid-term goal will be 20 kg. So the whole spectrum is basically you give them an idea that goal setting is not that it's one lump something looking at this. You try to do short-term goal and you give them, as a coach, you give them advice. For example, you give them simple idea of how to change their diet. You check through their list of their lifestyle, in which, for example, they are eating a lot of junk food, a lot of fast food, a lot of carbohydrate, a lot of cakes and fizzy drinks and so on. So you can list out all those that's affecting her weight problem. But to do that, you want to give accounts coaching in terms of weight loss, you must be yourself, must be trim and fit. If you are just as obese as that person, then it will not work, because the person who you are going to coach says, look, you are just even worse than me. You're overweight by 50 kg. That will not work. So you must have a good lifestyle. So if you are tackling as a coach for weight loss, you yourself must have a decent body profile. All right, that means you are eating healthy, you are cutting down on carbohydrates, you are learning the tools in terms of how to be a health coach. Inshallah, when I finish this whole thing, I will also give you some more tips on being a health coach, because alhamdulillah, I'm trained in nutrition at a very high level, so I can give you this idea of how we can then help the ummah, because now we are eating a lot of junk food, fast food. We are actually destroying our whole body with pesticide, insecticide, all the resistant, drug resistant bacteria, viruses, pathogen, you name it. Everything is coming to our body, and we are causing this epidemic of disaster in terms of being overweight, in terms of having diabetes and having cancer, and so many of the challenges of the 21st century that we must face. Because the most obese people on this earth are from our brothers and sisters in the Middle East. And right now in Malaysia, we are becoming the number one in terms of obesity. So we must arm ourselves with the necessary knowledge. So if you want to be a coach in terms of healthy lifestyle, a coach to help in terms of weight loss, then you must have knowledge. So you must go through a course, at least having some basic idea of how to be a health coach for slimming or for weight loss and so on. So that, inshallah, is additional knowledge that you must have on the basis of what you have to do. But if you don't have that knowledge, then you refer. You get this girl, all right, Sally, and pass her to a mentor or a coach who have been trained in holistic health coaching. So then that person can help you. You don't try to do it your own DIY approach. So these are some basic ideas which I'll elucidate further in the next video to understand this G, the first G, the goal setting that you can do, and you split the goal for this person in terms of the short term, mid term and long term goal, inshallah. So remember, always strive to make ourselves good as a Khalifa of Allah on this earth, striving to make ourselves good, help others to be good and make the world good and pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah.